having school from 8 to 2 really does not work. It doesn't, it's not the same thing like being at actual school. We're not walking around in the hallways. We don't have advisory to check in with each other and study. It's not the same thing. So I don't know why we're pretending like it is.
All right, so today we're going to be talking about the effects of switching from in-person to virtual learning. So today we're going to have high school students from the School District of Philadelphia discussing how they're dealing with the transition and what they would like to change about it. Okay, so to start off, I'd like to ask about how you all feel about your schools or the school district's response to COVID-19 in terms of virtual learning.
I would say that my school seems to be responding pretty well to everything now. Like, I know that it's not completely easy for the students, nor is it easy for the staff, but they have been trying their best to plan out certain schedules and provide resources to the students so that we can try and have the best experience possible with these new conditions. So I think we're starting to adjust pretty well, and like, the longer that these things go on, we get more used to everything and it becomes like easier by the day.
I would agree with Amina. I think my school has been handling it pretty well. I know that for a lot of teachers are like really struggling during this time to like, because they have to like change either their curriculum to fit remote learning, or the students are, I know it's really hard for the students because remote learning is a lot different than it is in person, but I think the way that my school has really like helped us transition has been really good.
Prior to the school district, in the beginning, like when they were just getting things planned out, I was like really confused. I didn't think that it was a thorough enough plan. But in regards to my own school, Central, honestly, I think that they're trying the best that they can. They were trying to get the freshmen back in school. And a lot of us, like, we were like, why? Like, why would you even want to put them at risk? Like, why would that even be a possibility? But I got the opportunity to talk to somebody within administration. And essentially, they were just explaining how statistics show that if freshmen are not engaged within their school environment, they're more likely to drop out. And so that is just something that they really wanted to deter.
Yeah, so just to talk about the school and the school district's response to COVID. So Central High School, I feel as though they're doing the best that they can do. Like Kiki said, we have resources. Our teachers are like posting assignments. They're teaching, like they're doing what a school should be doing. In terms of the school district, throughout this couple of months that we've been in school, there were a myriad of agendas that kind of changed as we went by. So like 1 week, you would think that we were going to go back to school in November. And then the next week, they were like, no, we're not going back to school in November. And it would change as time went by. But that's just how it works with stuff like this. And we are at a time of unprecedented circumstances, so it is, it makes sense that there's a lot of confusion. Dealing with, you know, school online and talking about resources, we'd like to touch on mental health issues. So are counseling services available and accessible through virtual learning at your schools? And if so, have they been effective?
From what I see on the platform we use, our counselors are split like based on grade. So there's like different counselors for each grade. And on like on the homepage of one of the sites that we use, there are like counselors and staff members who post like resources for calming anxiety, calming stress, and saying things like, if you have questions about this, or if you need help with this, you can reach out. And they provide contact information for students to reach out and speak to someone if they need it.
So just recently, my school has announced like counseling services being available. I think the way that it's set up, it's like an after hours type thing. You like set an appointment and you like talk to them. I haven't heard of anybody who has went, so I don't know if I can really speak on the effectiveness on it, but I don't know. I don't think that a lot of people within my school would be quick to even entertain the opportunity, because I know a lot of us don't necessarily feel supported when we're actually within school. And this isn't something that's just a reflection of our actual counselors. It's just a reflection of there being so many of us, like plus 2,000, and there only being like 4 counselors.
In my school, I know that the counselors have like an office hour set up, but the only time I've really heard that being used is, or like being promoted, is for help with like college stuff, like college questions, or like, you know, like trying to navigate applying to colleges. I haven't really heard anyone, staff or student, say like, oh, if you need, like, if you're struggling with something, like come to visit the counselors at their office hours, which I feel like I think it could have been a given, but I also haven't heard that advertised as much as just been applying for colleges.
Building on that, there's also this breach within the teacher to student relationship. And I just wanted to ask if you guys feel comfortable with how you are with your teachers, or is there a certain breach in your relationship now that you are in this virtual environment?
For me, I would say that I've gotten to know most of my teachers pretty well, and they're all pretty generous, and they seem to have like a sense of understanding, and they kind of like to, like, they're good at giving reassurance, and they do let us know that they're there for us if we need anything. And I do feel like it makes me feel much more comfortable and a little more hopeful, because I can see that my teachers do care and they want to see everybody thrive, and they are there to help with anything, and they try their best to give us what we need to get through the school year.
I feel like there's just going to be an inherent breach, because it's like it's online, like I'm not even seeing them face to face. Like there's times where they glitch out and I don't even know what it is that they said. I glitch out, they don't even know what I said. And I guess it just worries me, because I feel like going to the school that I go to, a lot of us just think like college is the main goal. Like we need to get to college. Once we get to college, like we've checked this off our bucket list, we're okay. And with it being my junior year, I know it's really important to just establish relations with a lot of my teachers and allow them to like get an understanding of who it is I am and that type of thing. And I don't feel like a lot of them can gain an understanding on that through a screen.
Yeah, so in terms of like assignments, I do feel like most of my teachers are flexible with like schedule, like due dates and stuff like that. Like they understand that we can't do as much as we used to be able to do in-person learning. One thing that I think Kiki touched on is about like teachers trying to get to know us to be able to write about us for recommendation letters and whatnot. And they emphasize trying to go to office hours, which are out of school hours. They try to emphasize us to email them. And it's like, well, there's only so much I can email about, and there's only so many office hours to go to. And they're all by appointment. And, you know, there's a lot of people who are in line to talk about various topics, right? So trying to build that connection in class and trying to also have time after school for yourself to be able to, like, actually do your assignments, it's hard to actually, like, build an actual relationship with these teachers because it takes up so much more time. Whereas in school, you would just be able to talk to your teacher after class, during class, or an advisory in the morning. I think that there's just more effort that needs to be put in with trying to create a relationship. Do you feel like you're more distracted now, or are you more focused when your teachers are teaching? I know a lot of students have been struggling with distractions. So can you guys just speak on how that has been throughout this virtual learning experience?
I've never been more distracted in my life, like ever. Never to this extent. Like even in class, you know, I'd be like dazing off a little bit, like falling asleep a little bit, but you know, I could wake up. You know, my teacher could stare at me. I could feel it, and I could realize I need to pay attention. I mean, I try to create a routine for myself. Like, I don't do class in bed because I know that's going to turn into me sleeping the entire day. But even with me setting up the routine that I have, I don't know, it's still not school. Like, it's not the environment in which I usually learn things in.
I can't do homework in bed either. I have this desk, and when I am in class, before class, I have to like clear off the desk of anything that I could be used to like play with or anything, because then I'll just be super distracted. Like, I have a routine for myself so that I can just stay as focused as possible in class. So I definitely do feel like it's a lot harder to focus when it's on virtual school, because it's just so simple to just be like, oh, I'm going to turn the volume down on my computer and I'm going to be on my phone.
I'm still not fully used to being here so much at home. So I have caught myself trying to do school in bed multiple times, and it never really worked out for me, which is no surprise. I think now for me, it's just a sense of self-discipline, and I need to, like, I try to set like weekly schedules and try to stay more organized so I can figure out what I need so that I'm able to be fully aware in class.
I think I have been functioning in the opposite way, as all of you have said, because I started off doing my work at my desk, and that's where I used to go to sleep. I would be at my desk, and then like my eyes would start like shutting. But when I'm in my bed, I feel like that's where I used to do my work all the time. So I made my bed my desk. Like, behind me, I have all my books like in a shelf, and all of my work is like accessible to me. So I think I made this my comfort zone, and this is where I'm comfortable doing my work. But in terms of focusing, I'll find myself on my phone for like 2 minutes. I'll say, oh yeah, I'm just gonna check Instagram for a couple of minutes. Next thing you know, our teacher's telling us that class is over. So it's, that has happened more than that should have happened, you know? So, you know, with all of the things that you guys have been experiencing throughout this virtual learning environment, do you think that there needs to be a significant amount of improvement or change in how our administrators are fostering this environment?
Just to begin, I feel like we've normalized and adapted to just a very, very terrible situation. But just to continue, I feel like something that needs to be done is the way that education is going. I feel like it needs to be made in a way that caters to the many needs that students have. Like this learning style, this structure does not work for a lot of people. I know, especially within quarantine, a lot of people our age have gotten jobs to either support their family or save for college. And just this schedule of us having school from 8 to 2 really does not work. It's not the same thing like being at actual school. We're not walking around in the hallways. We don't have advisory to check in with each other and study. It's not the same thing. So I don't know why we're pretending like it is. I personally feel like the best schedule that worked for me was back when we first introduced the first plan, and we were implementing A and B days, and we'd have like 2 classes a day, but they'd be extended classes, but those would be your only classes for the day. And you would be able to get your homework in like maybe by Wednesday, then the next day it'd be your next 2 periods, and it would just repeat. I know that works for me, but yeah, all I'm saying is I feel like we need something that can work for not necessarily everybody, but for the majority at least.
I think that's a great point that Kiki brought up, that virtual school is not the same as it is in person. So it's really strange or unnecessary for them to be like trying to treat it the same, when like virtual school is definitely a lot harder than like being school in person. So it should cater to that. I think that, at least for my school, I think that it is a lot different. And well, when we first started this in like March and April, whatever, the teachers would give an assignment. We didn't have Zoom calls. We didn't really have Google Meets with all like office hours. And I understand why they can't do that now, because there has to be some form of structure or school. But I think the let's have a Zoom call and let's have a teacher lecture for an hour isn't really helping anybody. So I think that there should definitely be a better, like, a better remote learning should adapt to the kids who, like, just need help during this time, instead of trying to treat it as, like, we're in person, but now it's online, if that makes sense.
I think our school district didn't really plan for resources. So for laptops, I believe there were only, like, a couple of locations that were open for a certain amount of time, and there were very, very, very long lines in order to get Chromebooks. And now throughout virtual learning, I find it very hard to work with one device. Like, I would need to use my phone at times because, you know, technical difficulties are a thing. We are working with computers and phones and tablets and whatnot. So they're like, they just assume that, like, oh, well, most people have computers already, and that we'll only need to be able to give a small amount of people computers and it'll be fine. But in reality, it really isn't. But so I think that the resourcing was kind of off with the planning. But yeah, in general, I think that we need to, like, come to a reality check when it comes to most of these things. So within this whole pandemic in general, regardless of virtual learning and whatnot, what have you been doing to cope with your new lifestyle within the pandemic? What are your coping mechanisms? And just, you know, share with us what you have been doing throughout this pandemic to keep yourself sane.
So this pandemic really, it did a lot for me. Yeah. So, like, prior to the pandemic, like, I was my sophomore year, which I feel like a lot of people have the same connotation of, is just really stressful. It's just hard for a lot of people. And so I was involved in several extracurriculars, just having a very fast-paced life. And quarantine and the pandemic, like, it was a violent halt, like nothing I've ever experienced before. And I know a lot of us can attest to that. So it launched me into a depressive episode. And to cope, I listened to music, which is why my Spotify Unwrapped looks so atrocious. Yeah. But, like, as quarantine went on and I was, like, able to find more ways to cope, I went back to, like, my old habits of keeping myself busy. But since it's, like, online, I can't, like, I don't know, I can't overwhelm myself as easily. So it hasn't turned into anything negative.
For me, the quarantine kind of, like, ruined my, like, coping mechanisms before, so to speak. Like, before the pandemic, if I was feeling, like, down or had a rough week, I would, like, go hang out with my friends, or I would go shopping, or I would, like go out and try to, like, get myself out of my head and whatever. And so that's when it, like, really hit me that, like COVID-19 was, like, a thing. It was, like, when I was feeling down or when I had a rough week, I couldn't, like, go hang out with my friends. And then I was just, like, even more, like, depressed, because I was, like, well, what am I supposed to be doing? So I think after, like, a few weeks of that, I kind of, like, fell back into my, like, middle school, like, stuff. Like, I started, like, rereading books that I loved. I started to, like, make appointments to talk to my friends over FaceTime. I started to, like, write things and kind of just, like, do creative stuff that I hadn't done in a while because I had, like, been so busy. I started to, like Kiki said, I started to listen to a lot of music that I had already loved music, but now I had more time to, like, sit down and, like, review it and talk to myself, obviously, about, like, the production and the lyrics and just kind of get more in depth with it.
I was always somebody who would distract myself constantly and tell myself that I had to be busy. I had to be doing something. I always avoided, I never wanted to really take time to reflect on things and, you know, to think. I just didn't like getting caught up in my head. So over quarantine, like, I really took the time to give myself rest days and get a better sense of who I was and what I liked. And I became much more comfortable and confident in who I am and what I like. So I discovered new artists and I got back into reading. And now that I got back into it, like, I love it here and I really don't want to get out of this thing. So I love reading and journaling and getting more involved in extracurriculars. And yeah, just doing things more for me now, because before I usually didn't do that. So I'm much more content with myself. And quarantine has been a good opportunity for me to self-reflect.
Quarantine really, like, the whole pandemic really shifted my whole way of life. So just starting off with school, school used to be a very important part of my life. It still is, but just going to school was, like, very important, not only in academics, but just, like, being able to talk to people, to communicate with people, and getting to connect with all types of people from all over the city, especially since Central High School has, like, such a diverse set of students from all over Philly, from basically anywhere. And then, like, just having that all shut down and just being contained in, like, four walls with the four, like, same people was so different for me. So I did definitely have to adapt to that. And in terms of coping mechanisms, I developed a new phase almost every week. It was horrendous, but, like, I mean, I went through it. So at one point I was making bracelets. At one point I went back to drawing. At one point I started writing. At one point I started SAT practicing. I haven't done SAT practice since then, right? So, like, I was just going through a bunch of phases to try to, like, adapt to this new sense of, like, openness and, like, freedom almost. But it has been hard for me to kind of, like, fully adapt to that, and I'm still in the adaptive process. But nonetheless, I do think that I have grown as a person throughout the pandemic and definitely have learned a lot more about myself and about others, which I am very thankful for. So thank you, everybody, for sharing and joining us today. And thank you all for watching today's table talk, and I hope you enjoyed.